ladies and gentlemen, this is Rob with Deluxe Gaming, and welcome back to FortressCraft Evolved, Day 6. So, Jim Bob won't stop laughing. Stop it! Stop laughing! Because, apparently, I can't do math. So, yes, in case you missed yesterday's episode, 10% of 30,000 is not 300. It is 3,000, and 10% of 300,000 is 30,000. I don't know what I was thinking. I think I had a really good time this weekend with my family. Or, maybe being around my family makes me dumber. I don't know. Can't tell. But anyway, Jim Bob won't stop laughing. What's wonderful about all that is that it's on the internet forever. So 2 years from now, I'm still going to be getting messages after the first time somebody watches that video going, you can't do math. Ah, it's great. If you can't share your shame on the internet, where can you share it, right? So, wonderful thing. Anyway, I feel like my brain is starting to return to normal. So hopefully today we can have some really good plays. So first things first, we've got a couple things that we need to take care of. I'm going to make some basic conveyor belts, and I'm going to hold down the control button, and look at this. So if I hit control and hit craft, it'll build 25 times 5, which is 125. See, math, I can do that now. So I've got 133. Actually, we're going to do another one of those, because we've got the extra copper right now. I think that's what we're going to do. Yeah, so there, we've got 258 of the basic conveyor belts. And why did I do that? Well, first things first, let's deal with this copper mine over here. We want to make it so that we can access it from the base. Somebody had suggested that the other day, and I just never got around to it. So quickly, we'll remove this. We will go to our storage, which is tab 3. We'll put down a logistics hopper, and we're going to just build some conveyors straight up. And, you know, I mean, I still have to collect from this one, but I'm not going to build automation all the way to the base. I could. I mean, it wouldn't be a big deal to do that, but, well, okay, I guess I got to dig straight up. But, you know, I still, you know, either way, it doesn't matter. As long as I can access it from the base, that'll be fine. So there we go. Should work now. Oh, light's in the way, that's why. There we go, all the way up. And we will build it up just a little bit more so that I can see it nicely from the base. Get on there. Perfect. And up. There we go. Perfect. That'll be great. And then we're going to stick a storage hopper right on top. We're going to rotate that around. And perfect. So now, all of those, yes, they should go straight up and fill up the storage hopper. So another thing I'd like to do really quickly, actually, there's a couple things we need to do. So with our tin mine, so this basic conveyor belt with the setting of conveyors on is slow, is enough to handle one mine with a basic motor attached. Those two things combined are perfect. They will work in perfect. So long as there's room in the refinery, this will work perfectly. However, there is one thing that I need to fix here is the storage hopper. Whoops, didn't mean to fall. So right now we've got a logistics hopper attached to that mine, which is just slow enough that it actually causes some breaks in the process of getting tin. So you can't see it here, probably because it was the refinery was full at the time. But we want to make that completely fluent, so we're going to build one storage hopper to replace the logistics hopper that we have here, and then it'll be perfectly fine. See, we probably have a little bit of a buildup in here. Yeah, see, there's 27 ore in here. Yeah, if we replace this with a storage hopper, this mine will run absolutely 100% efficiently. So isn't that great? We are going to need more mines here, of course. But right now, we can't handle too much more anyway because we only have one refinery. No point in going too crazy. Next thing on the list is we want to get... I promised this experiment. We just never did it yet. Or we haven't done it yet. So we need to get this going. We need to get the Mynock experiment going. We still... I mean, no point... Oh, 84. Let me just grab this lithium... the resources from this lithium mine very quickly, because it's been a while since I've been down here, apparently, and it's going to be around the 80s. So yeah, I promised to do this experiment with the Mynocks right away. I just haven't done it yet. So let's do that now. I mean, we need to get some... We can't automate iron or lithium up to the base quite yet because we don't have defenses for our conveyors. But that doesn't change the fact that we need to do this experiment. We promised, so we're going to do it. We're going to do it right now. Okay, actually, let's get rid of this... let's see, are we gonna do it? You know what? I think we're gonna do it one end. So we're gonna change the size of the tunnel. It's gonna be a 3x4, I think, in doing this. We're gonna need more room in here, so that's all. So I think that's a really good idea. So yeah, so we'll go like that, and like that, like that. Whoops. Little much. I got a little crazy there. It happens. There we go. Perfect. And we will start building our conveyors from here. So let's, of course, they're going to attach to these bottom ones, but I mean, you know, we're going to build them all the way up. We're going to be building them all the way up anyway. So yeah, there we go. Whoops. Oh, what happened? There we go. Make sure that's the right way. Yep, they sure are. Okay, there we go. And let's go all the way up. Okay, there we go. So we've got the conveyor going all the way up from the bottom. It's, I think it's only, what is it? It's like 100. That's 100 meters down. I mean, it's a fair ways down. But now we're going to be able to see exactly where the Mynocks are going to attach. So we're just going to let that sit. We're going to let that brew. We're going to let the Mynocks think about what they've done. They haven't done anything yet. I mean, so there's a rumor. I've heard a rumor that Mynocks, when they eat ore, the ore actually goes somewhere, so it doesn't actually disappear. And if that's the case, that's kind of cool. I have no idea where they go, but I mean, where does the iron go? Or where does it go? I have no idea. But anyway, so just a note. Okay, so while I'm here, I'm just going to fill the hoppers here. Fill them right up with some iron, because we're a little short on iron. Really, what we should do is we should build an extra iron mine. Actually, let's do that right away. Let's get another mine down there. I think because, you know, it's funny. We're going to need a lot of iron right now. And we're going to build another basic drill motor. We're going to build another. We need a lot of iron right now because we're building a lot of storage hoppers and a lot of mines and stuff like that. But then we're not going to need as much iron for a while. And then we're going to need an enormous amount of iron. So, I don't know. But I think right now we just, oh, you see, the Mynocks, they came to the party. They're here. They're ready. Oh, looks like I screwed up somewhere here. All right, we'll fix that in a second. Or, I mean, it's not even necessary to fix that up right now. Okay, so let's get that there. And what we're going to... Oh, we need some light down here again, too. So let's get some more light down here. And might as well just throw this mine right here. And we'll get that pumped up with another economy drill motor. And we're going to throw down one more storage hopper, like so. And away we go. I will meet you upstairs. Right. So next on the list is we need to do some research to get access to weaponry, automated weaponry, so that we can defend our conveyor belts that are below ground from things like Mynocks. So how are we going to do that? Well, we need to get local life forms, I think. So let's research that. And then that would give us access to base defense. Yes. Oh, we got to wait until we need 800 power for that. So just about, there we go. And then with that, that should give us access to some guns that we can put up, some automated guns. There is a problem with that. We're going to need some really weird material. We need iron plates, charged PCBs. What are those? So there's two types of turrets. There's one that uses hardened PCBs and iron plates, and another one, and tin bars, and another one that uses charged PCBs and iron plates and tin bars. Well, these two things are odd things, and they're actually material used in researching. So I just happen to know that. So if we did some research on advanced research, it'll give us access to some... Oh, I guess we got to wait for power to fill in there. That's fine. It'll give us access to some devices we can use or some machines we can use to make those things like PCBs and hardened plates. But until we get these turrets in that shaft, we're not going to be able to bring anything up via conveyor belt because of those Mynocks. Yeah, so that is definitely the next thing we need to do. We just got to wait for this silly thing. Actually, it's not that far away. I think, what do we need? 800? There we go. Done. 800. There we go. So now with that, that opens up a whole line of machinery. These guys here. We have the stamper plant, the extrusion plant, the coiler plant, the PCB assembling plant, and the pipe extrusion plant. It's you know what? Don't even worry about what these are called. It doesn't even matter. The point is, this thing makes plates. This thing makes wires. This thing makes coils of wires. This thing makes control boards. Plastic control boards, something. It's control boards anyway. So PCBs, and all of them can use any materials. In other words, there's copper plates, there's tin plates, there's iron plates. Pretty straightforward. And then PCBs right up to, anyway, well, first thing we need to build them in order to actually, although we may not even have the material to build some of this stuff. So first thing we can build is the stamper plant. We can't build the extrusion plant until we've actually created some tin plates and copper plates. Well, how do we do that? We do that with the stamper plant, and it's just tin and copper to build that. So let's get that built. And I often put those on my F5 on my keyboard. So let's put the stamper plant as number one, and we're going to build that machinery over on this side. Our research is probably going to, we're going to eventually build a big laboratory right here, and these machines will need to link up to that laboratory. So we're going to start off with our stamper plant, and I think we'll put that, I don't know, like right here. It doesn't really matter. Just an arbitrary place right now. And we're going to need to get a couple of hoppers. Let's do just these straight up mini hoppers. Crafting. My preference. And we've got some, I wonder if we could build some just, we're gonna build some regular conveyor belts. Now these things are like, what are they, 5 times crafting. Faster than the basic ones? Crafting. Like they are substantially faster. So we'll just build 2 of those right now. And we're going to build some plates. So what did we need again for the turret? So there's 2 different types of turrets. Let's talk about those first. Turret Mark 1, it has a range of only 16 meters, which is actually, I mean, it's pretty small if you think about it, but that is 32 meters around, right? So 32 meters total, or 16 meters in every direction. And then there is the Turret Mark 2, which is 20 meters, so slightly longer range. Definitely want to go, I think, with the longer range. This one does more damage, but it probably, and it also requires more power, I think. Both of them require power. So to build these turrets, we're going to need a few things. We're going to need plates and PCBs. So first things, we're going to need some plates. So how do we build plates? Well, let's talk about that. Let's get a hopper. We're going to put a hopper here, and we're gonna put a hopper here, and I'm crazy. I like to see everything work on the conveyors. I don't know, it just makes me feel like things are actually happening. So I'm gonna put a conveyor here, and I'm gonna put a conveyor here, and whatever material bar of material I put into this side, it's gonna go through the stamper and create a plate out of it, and then put it onto this side. So to start out, we need to make some other machines eventually so that we can make let's work on the turrets. We're going to work on the turrets, and then we'll cross each bridge as we come to it. So first things first, we need iron plates, which means how many iron bars do we have on us right now? We have 7 iron bars, and we need how many iron plates? I think it's just 1 per turret. Yeah, so we're going to make use of all 7 bars. Why not? So we're going to hit 8 on the keyboard, and then we can use T to put those iron plates in the hopper, and it's going to move the hopper into the stamper plant. Stamper is going to go, chunk. And it flattens it eventually, there we go, and turns it into a plate. See that? It's pretty cool. And then at the end we have an iron plate. So we're gonna let that machine just do its thing. That's all we're gonna do. We're gonna let the machine do its thing. Now if we want to build any of these other machines, so let's just take a look at these, which we're gonna have to, and even to build our turrets, because we're gonna need PCBs. Well, how do we build PCBs? We have to take a bar and turn it into a wire, then turn that wire into a coil, and then turn that coil into a PCB. It's a 3-step process to create a PCB. So we are gonna have to build all 3 of these machines too as well. Well, to build these machines, we're gonna need some materials from each one of them. So for the extrusion plant, we're gonna need some copper plate and tin plate, 5 and 3. So let's get those going too. Let's get some, go 9, go to copper. And we're going to add 5 copper bar, which will eventually get us 5 copper plate. We're gonna need some tin plate too, but we're just gonna let that machine do its thing. In the meantime, we're gonna add some power here. And the thing about this game, especially if you're playing on sparse, just be patient. You know what? There's no reason to rush things. And if you're watching, well, it doesn't matter, because I'm gonna skip ahead until we get to the place where we have everything that we need, right? So you don't really have to worry about those parts. So while we're waiting, actually, I'm gonna go collect some stuff out of the mines, and I'll see you in a second. Okay, so we're ready to go. We've got 15 copper plates, we've got some tin plates, and of course we have our iron plates that we made at the beginning. So if I'm going too fast, I want to apologize to everybody, but at the same time, I don't know how much of this I should do tutorially and how much of this we should just play. So I don't know, because there's still a big part of this game that I just want to play because I haven't experienced it all. So anyway, so now we're going to go on and we're going to make the rest of the plants that we need. And we're going to completely ignore the pipe extrusion plant because we just don't need that right now. So, but what I do, like I said, is I like to keep everything on tab 5. It just makes everything really easy to remember. So stamper plant is the first plant, then the next one is the extrusion plant, and it's going to require copper plate and tin plate, which we have. And this one, just so everybody knows, I'm just going to bring this up, and we're going to put this on our bar. So this one is a plant to turn copper or turn bars into wire. And of course you can have tin wire, copper wire, iron wire. There's all the different flavors of wire too as well. So, and we're gonna build a couple of the hoppers. I like for this, at this point in the game, I like to have the mini hoppers and or logistics hoppers for this part. It just makes it a little easier to control the flow. And what I mean by that is, well, you can with a storage hopper, and also it costs extra resources to build the storage hoppers. But with these hoppers here, they can only hold 10, right? So I know when I go and I put, hit T on the keyboard to put them into this hopper, I can only maximum put 10. It's just a little bit easier to keep track of the flow. So I think we're gonna move the stamper plant and everything. We're gonna move all of this. So the stamper plant, we're gonna keep separate. We're gonna build that back up again right away here so that we can keep things from getting too confusing. So we're gonna go back here and we're gonna go mini hopper. And we're gonna put the second mini hopper here, and we're gonna put the plant in the center. Stamper plant, so this is how we make the plates. Make sure that's facing the right direction. I think that's right, yep. And we're gonna put, actually I'm gonna put on F5, I'm also gonna put the these guys here too as well. The we're gonna build a couple more, the regular conveyor belts. We're gonna use the regular conveyor belts for this one, not that it really matters. But anyway, so. We're gonna put this back together so it's ready to go. Go five and then like that, rotate, like that, rotate. So now we're gonna build another mini hopper. We're gonna put it, right here for now. That's fine. We're gonna probably move things as time goes on because we're gonna automate this whole process too as well in the end so that we can make, eventually make experimental pods which we can use for research, but we're not quite there yet. So first thing on the list is we're gonna do the plant that makes wire. So just to show you guys, to make the next item on the list, we're gonna need to have wire available to us. So the extrusion plant will make wire, and the coiler plant, we're gonna need wire to make the coiler plant. So we're also gonna need more copper plates, and I have enough for that already. So basically we're gonna make another little bit of wire, and actually we're gonna replace that one with, we're not going to use the mini hopper, we're going to use the logistics hopper for the reason that I pointed out already, because I can control the amount that goes in there pretty easily. So that's this way, when I hit T on the keyboard and I put the copper in there, only two is going to go in there. And actually we'll just remove that right away so that we're only doing one piece of wire, because we only need one piece of wire, and I hate collecting a bunch of stuff that we're not going to use right away. So let's put this, let's go back here, let's put the regular mini hopper back on here, and we're going to put a conveyor here. So see, it created a piece of wire, perfect. And we're gonna put another mini hopper here for now, and we're gonna collect that wire. There we go. So now we can take that copper wire that we just got, and we can go back to here, and we can hit E, and we can build the coiler plant. Oh, did I not build copper wire? Wait, what wire did I build then? Oh, I think I hit the wrong button here. Yep. I put another mini hopper in there for some reason. Okay, so I hit T instead of Q. All right, so now we can build the coiler plant, which can turn wire into coils of wire. So we're gonna put that back on our bar. So we're gonna go here, go to our tab F5, and we're gonna throw that sucker right on here. And it all seems kind of confusing at the beginning, but you know what? You get used to these machines aren't gonna change, and you use these all the time. So you get used to it. So we're gonna go three, and I'm not on the stamper plant, my bad. We're gonna actually add it to here. I'm not gonna worry about, yeah, we're gonna add it right to this one. I'm not gonna worry about putting another hopper here because the wire goes to the coiler, which coils the wire, right? So we're gonna throw that sucker here, and we're gonna put another one of these guys, and we're gonna put another hopper on the end to collect whatever. And I think, do we have to build any more of these machines? Yes, we still have to build the PCB assembling plant, but we're gonna need one piece of copper coil, or one coil of wire to do that. So how do we do that? Actually, let's go back here again. I guess it doesn't really matter, but, and we're gonna go to our bars, and we're gonna throw in, hit T on the keyboard, that'll put two in here. We're gonna remove this so it doesn't put another one through the line. It's gonna turn that copper bar into a piece of wire. Then it's gonna turn that piece of wire into a coil. Look at that, isn't that cool? Looks pretty cool. Once it starts to get to this point, it actually gets kinda cool. Then that goes into the little hopper, and we're gonna collect that. Perfect, and we should be able to build our PCB plant, which is just another machine that attaches to the end of this. We're gonna turn copper coils now into PCBs, which are basically little control boards. And you can, each different type of material has a different flavor of them. Of course, we're gonna fix this up eventually. I'm gonna get all this looking nice, but right now I just wanna get it done. So let's remove that, and let's go to our tab F5, and we're gonna add the PCB plant to the end here because it's in order. So the stamper's kind of on its own. The stamper makes plates, right? But then the coiler, or sorry, the extrusion plant makes wire. The wire turns into coils with the coiler plant. And then the coiler plant turns those coils into PCBs, which are like little control boards with the coils of wire. So we can attach that PCB plant to the end here, like so. And now that we've got this in place, we can make PCBs. So for every one bar we put in here, we'll create a PCB relative to that bar. So if we put in an iron bar at the beginning, it's going to create the version of the iron PCB at the end. Kind of cool, eh? So anyway, we're going to attach a... let's attach another one of these suckers. And yeah, and maybe we should have done the stamper on the other side. No. Probably gonna have to move this whole machine once I figure out what I'm gonna be doing here because I want to automate it for research. So we're gonna put a hopper on the end because now, if you remember, our goal here actually right now is to make turrets. Turrets are the big thing. So in order to make our turret Mark IIs, which is what I think we're gonna go for, we're gonna need iron plates, which we've already got, and charged PCBs. Now, if you're ever wondering, if you ever need more help on which is which, you can actually hit the H on the keyboard and go through and figure this stuff out. So if you go to, I think it's under guides, laboratory research, we'll give you sort of a rundown on basic research, and then you can go to the, let's see, actually, I wonder if it has PCBs in here. I'm sure it does. Anyway, it's not important. I just happen to know that charged PCBs are made with lithium. So, and we need how many of them? I mean, we're gonna build at least 7 turrets, right? So, I mean, we'll just throw in a whole block of 10. And basically, we're going to put in 10 blocks or bars of lithium. So I'm going to go 7 and hit T and put in 10 bars of lithium. It's going to turn that lithium into wire. Then it's going to turn that wire into coils of wire. Then it's going to turn those coils of wire into PCBs. And then it's going to spit it out here. So kind of neat. But it is going to take a few minutes because these mini hoppers operate very, very slowly. We could do this faster, but there's really what's the rush, right? Just one moment. Okay, so that is in progress. That's going to take a few minutes. So next thing on the list is we need to get some more power because there's no way that our base is going to continue to support our habit of building lots and lots of things that require lots of power. Turrets are one of those things that are going to require a lot of power. We could add a generator right here, or we could do, I'm not sure. I think we could take the load off of the base and remove everything we're doing downstairs and put it onto generators. So the generator is basically just another way to generate energy, and it by burning coal. Oh, speaking of coal, we need to power this sucker up. And we could actually have the generator attached to this coal mine somehow so that it's basically perpetual energy, right? Well, sort of perpetual energy. We do have to add material to it. So how are we doing here? Are we just about done with PCBs? No, we still got 5 more to go. So let's think about building a generator. And I was kind of hoping to build a generator near this thing. Now we need to juice up here. And you know what? I'm going to move everything around here. It's a given. I am definitely going to be moving everything around because you know what? I think what we'll do is we will set up the generator right here. That way this generator, so basically this generator is going to take from this hopper, this storage hopper, which has coal in it, and it's going to burn that power. So you can see in the bottom left, it's current power. It's generating 10 per second, 10 power per second, and it's got a burn time of about a minute with that each piece of coal. So, and it can store up to 1,000 points of power too as well, which is great. Now, if we go ahead and we attach, actually, let's build a power block here, power storage block. Ah, we don't have any tin? Really? Wow, we burn through tin like crazy. Yeah, this is a point in the game where you start going through, start going through a lot of tin. we may have to step up our game when it comes to our tin mine. But yeah, so let's build the power storage block. Like so. And we can just slap that sucker right beside the coal mine, and boom, we've got perpetual power. The coal gets spit out into the hopper. The hopper will spit out the coal into the generator. The generator will spit out power into the power storage block and then circle around. So isn't that great? So now with this, we can actually use this power also to power our new defense system. And I'm thinking we could actually use it to power our mines down there too as well. But now we'll just focus on the defense system with this one. I don't know, actually, I'm a little torn on this one. because I'm thinking I want to use this power also. No. This power is also going to be powering our research as well as just our defenses down below. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a mess of things. Let's build some more laser transmitters. Let's build four of those, and we're going to build at least two power storage blocks. So now, we actually should be able to grab some of these PCBs. 9 charged PCBs. Oh, I've got one more coming. That's fine. We'll just let it cook. Finish cooking. That's fine. And we can take those PCBs. We can come over here. We're almost out of time. I'm trying to rush through this so that we can actually get a turret up. But, we need 10. I knew it. We're going to be shortfall on something. 10. Bloody 10. Okay, so well, we can continue to build some of the infrastructure here. I think what we'll do is we will throw a laser, frickin' laser, going this way, and then we're going to I'm not sure at this point. What we could do, it's gonna get messy out here. I mean, we've just got a lot going on, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to have that going from here. And part of this is also knowing where the Mynocks are going to attach. Because the point of these guns is to beat up the Mynocks, right? And if the Mynocks, you know, stop at 80 or stop at 70, you know, or whatever they are going to stop at, then we know where to start placing these turrets. So, and we're going to put another one of these guys right here. Like so. Oh, that's not going to work. That's not gonna work at all. Let's do that one up, like right there. Perfect. Go up here. Sometimes I rush, and I know when I rush, I make mistakes. It's, you know, I try to keep these episodes running at a really decent time for you know, really decent pace for you guys, so that, you know, I don't feel like I'm wasting anybody's time. All right, so that is going okay. That's fine. And of course, when I rush, I do silly things like that too as well. Okay, so that's fine. Let's go. It's going to come in right about here. Oh, that might work out pretty good. Just have to make this look okay. Haha. So, and we're going to put a power storage block here. Yes. And we're going to be going straight down with those. I have to make this look normal though, because if I don't make this look normal, like I'm gonna be cutting, like I'm cutting all of this. So, and I don't like things just, you know, levitating in the air. It just doesn't look right to me, and I know it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, and I know you guys will be like, "What does it matter? It doesn't matter." But it matters to me. It matters to me. It has to look like it's physically possible. If it doesn't look like it's physically possible, then it's gonna bug me. It's gonna bug the crap out of me. So let's. Grapple onto here. Perfect. And perfect. Yeah, this is going great. So then we're going to attach the laser going straight down from here. I guess we can keep that one in. Perfect. And this light can go. It's going to fall all the way down. That's okay. And, yeah. Whoops. Ow. Hold on. I need to... So I guess we're going to start to see where the Mynocks are... begin and end here too. Oh, I guess I better grab this ore while I'm here. I changed it around a little bit so that we've got the two storage blocks on the opposite sides of the mines. Just makes more sense that way. There we go. Collect that one. Okay, so now, turrets. How much time do we have? We have like no time. We are like literally out of time here. Well, a couple minutes. You know what? Doesn't hurt. Okay, so let's grab some of this. We're gonna go up. So, like I said, each one of these turrets will cover 40 meters. So, okay, let's go down. And the thing is, we need to know where the Mynocks start. And I have a feeling it's going to be around 75-ish. I mean, I don't know, but I think. I don't know. Let's go down over here. This is kind of a funny way to get around, but, you know, it works. Get rid of this one. And If it's starting at actually 80 would be convenient, because then we'd have two turrets to cover the full 80, I think is probably ideal. And we could assume that. So what level is this? Hold on, let's just take a look here. This is at minus 84 meters. Oh, so even at 84 meters, or so, Whoops, hold on. So there's Mynock showing up at minus 85? Is that right? So I wonder if they'll go right up to 80. I don't know. We could assume 80 and build two turrets. I mean, that's probably the most convenient way to do it. So that means we're going to have to build one at minus 40. So, oh, and we're almost out of juice. Okay, let's go back down. I just want to get one turret up today. And actually, we should only need one turret then, I think. I think one turret would cover at least that main, the main shaft, I think. So let's go back up here. Okay, so we're at minus 106. If we did it at minus 100, we should be able to cover everything, I think. So let's just go down. I guess I gotta go up. Sorry, my bad. Okay, so 101. So let's go up by one. And we're gonna build... our new laser. I think that's the new laser right there. Oh, right. He is... We've got to extend his range. That's right. So we've got to go back up here. Sorry, guys. I know we're out of time. My little timer's going off. Okay, so... But I want to get this up before we go. Because I promised. But if I put this turret up, we're never going to see where those Mynocks stop living, right? Or stop... occupying. Okay, let's go right on top. Here comes laser. Okay, let's just extend his range right here. We're gonna have to get some more of these too as well. There we go. Extend his range right there. Perfect. And actually, we could do it sort of in line with the other one, actually. That would look better, I think. Don't you think? Let's do that. That makes more sense. And so let's go back down to 100. Okay, so now we should have the second line, which is right here. And we're at 100 meters. Perfect! And we should be able to put this sucker here. And now we can actually put a turret here, but we're going to wait. I'm going to wait until next time. We are in place, though, to put a turret right here. And that will defend this entire line from Mynocks. It should, anyway, all the way to the bottom. Because I think the bottom is what? What? Oh, maybe it needs to be a little bit lower, actually. So, you know what? I will adjust that for next time. We are out of time anyway. I will shift that power block down just a little bit so it covers the whole range, because the bottom is 128. So, yeah, it needs to come down by about 8 minus 108. And then it should be able to cover the entire range up here. But I want to see where the Mynocks stop appearing. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of FortressCraft. We will see you again tomorrow. Take care.